welcome back to How to Make Ginger Wine Part 2. Today we're going to show you what to do next. Hopefully your wine has stopped fermenting, you've stopped seeing bubbles in the airlock. Maybe it's reduced to maybe one bubble every 2 minutes. So we'll have a look at the wine, we're going to sterilise our equipment and move on to the next stage. Okay, so it's been 18 days since the wine's been fermenting. If we have a look at the airlock, there's really not much activity going on in there at all. You're looking for maybe like one bubble every 1 to 2 minutes. See, that was that, and it'd probably be about another minute before the next one. So we're going to have to check the gravity to make sure fermentation has stopped. Okay, the equipment we're going to need, sterilise our equipment again. So you're going to need to sterilise a 1 gallon fermentation bucket. In here we've got sterilising a turkey baster, so we can do the gravity of the wine, the final gravity. You need a pestle and mortar. The mortar's just under there. A spoon, some siphon tubing, your hydrometer, and I've got myself a cylinder now, so a cylinder to put the wine in to drop the hydrometer in. Leave that for about an hour or so to sterilise, depending on the instructions on the packet. Then give it a good rinse, and then we'll move on to the next stage. Okay, so the first thing you need is some fermentation stopper. You can see that there. Or wine stabiliser. Next you'll need some Campden tablets. We're going to use some finings. These are the best ones, quick clear finings. And then to sweeten it, to finish it, a bottle of glycerine. And some wine sweetener. Okay. Okay, so we have our wine. What we want to do is take your pipette or your turkey baster. You want to get some of the juice, and then we're going to put it into a cylinder here so that we can then check the final gravity. So what you have to do is drop it into this, give it a good spin and see where it lands. Now, I put far too much sugar in this at the very beginning. So it's reached a point where it can't ferment anymore, and we are at 1.3. Just there, you can see it just about. We're at 1.3. It's probably not going to ferment anymore because the airlock has stopped bubbling. What we could do if we wanted to take it to dry, which would be down here at 0.990. is we could add some champagne yeast or some turbo yeast, which is the yeast that's used to fermenting at high levels of alcohol. So pretty much I've killed all the yeast and it's reached its highest potential alcohol, which could be anything between 14% and 15%. So because it's at 1.3, we're going to stop now. We're going to try and kill off all the yeast. And we won't have to back sweeten the wine so much, because if you taste this now, it's got a little bit of sweetness to it. It's quite nice. So yeah, we'll move on to the next stage. Okay, so the next step is to rack the wine. Now I've attached some tubing. What you have to do is basically give a suck on the end of the tubing. And then you want to put it into another clean, sterilised fermentation bucket. So if we try and do that now, I'll show you what it looks like. Okay, so the wine is coming down the tubing. Follow it back up to that. You have to do it on a higher level so that gravity does all the work for you. We're just working it into a clean fermentation bucket. This also helps with degassing the wine, which we'll talk about later. So after racking, you're left with the juice. It's still cloudy. If you've got some sediment in there, that's absolutely fine, because we're going to clear it later. What's left in the demijohn is just all the yeast that's kind of dead or asleep at the bottom. So we're going to have to clean out the demijohn, sterilise it again, give it a good rinse, and then we'll move on to the next stage. So we're just sterilising our bottle at the moment with some sterilising solution. If you can see, there's like bits of dirt on the inside where we were fermenting it for so long. You might want to get yourself demijohn bottle cleaner, which you just sort of put in there, and it helps just give it a good clean. It's quite difficult getting it in at first, but once it's in, you can clean around the edges of your bottle, which makes it so much easier and obviously so much more hygienic. Okay, so you've given the demijohn a good clean, you let it sit for a while, sterilising. So basically, siphon all the juice back in. Don't leave any in the bottom, you want to get it all in there. So. Okay, so we've put our the fermentation stopper, which is the potassium sorbate, into a pestle and mortar. We're going to add one Campden tablet. The fermentation stopper, potassium sorbate, does exactly what it says on the tin. It stops the fermentation process and it stabilises the wine. And the Campden tablet we add basically because it can kill bacteria, and it also stops the wine having a funny taste because we've added that. So we've put them in there together. Just want to give it a good grind with the pestle and mortar, and then we're going to add, you can either add some warm water or a bit of the wine into there. So we want to basically make sure it's all dissolved. There's a teaspoon of the fermentation stopper in there and just one Campden tablet. Some of the wine is in there. It kind of looks like it's all dissolved now. It might take a few minutes. So then what we want to do, basically, is pour that into our wine. Now it needs a really good shake. Do you remember what we said before about the pressure inside the demijohn? You shouldn't really shake it. So what I do is I use the bung, which I put on. Put a bit of tissue over the top and then release the gas as I shake. You need the tissue because it does literally spray out. What we'll do, we'll shake that a few times. Also, we want to get the gas out. We call it degassing. So we want to get the gas out of here. So we're going to give it a good shake. I'll show you how to do that. So we're going to put this on over the bunghole, give it a good shake a few times, and then release that. You can hear a little hiss, a little fizz. As you lift it, get a bit of the juice out as well. That's why we use the tissue. We're going to do that probably about 10 times, just until you don't hear that hiss anymore. So we've done that a couple of times. We degassed the wine. We want to put the bung with the airlock back on. Leave it in the same place we had it before, for about 2 or 3 days, making sure the temperature's not too high or too low. And then after 2 to 3 days, we're going to add some finings. Or you can leave it for a couple of months and let nature take its course, and it will clear naturally. You have to rack it maybe a few more times just to make sure it's like crystal clear. But we're going to cheat. We're going to use some finings just to make it nice and clear. But yeah, leave that for 2 to 3 days. Okay, so it's been 3 days and the fermentation has hopefully stopped. There was no bubbles in the airlock the whole time, so it's definitely stopped. The wine will start to look like it's clearing a little bit. You could leave that. You could rack it maybe every couple of months, and it would naturally clear. We're going to cheat, we're going to use some finings. It's a two-part fining kit. You can get that online with the homebrew websites or Amazon will sell it. We're going to add part A. You have to read the packet carefully because different finings have different instructions. So we have to add 2 ml of part A, which is just under half a teaspoon. If you've got a syringe, even better. So we're going to use one of these measuring spoons. So we've just put just under half a teaspoon in there. So we're going to pop that in. Now we have to give it a little bit of a shake and leave it for half an hour, and then we'll put in part B. Okay, so it's been half an hour since we put findings A in. Now we're going to put some findings B into the demijohn. It's changed colour a little bit because I had to shake it up, which brought all the sediment back up again. So we'll just put just under half a teaspoon of part B in there. We're going to put the bung back in, give it a good shake, and then leave it now for 2 to 3 days until it basically becomes crystal clear. So what you want to do is, after you've put the bung and the airlock back in, for the next 2 to 3 days, you want to leave it on a raised surface, like the kitchen top, so that you can then siphon it basically. You need it to be on a raised level. If you clear it somewhere else and then move it, you risk kicking up all the sediment again from the bottom, so it just make it all cloudy. So it's best to leave it somewhere high to clear for the next 2 to 3 days. Okay, so it's been 2 days and the wine, as you can see, is pretty clear. All the sediment's at the bottom. We're ready to siphon it. We're going to siphon it into a clean fermentation bucket with some siphon tubing. Okay, so when you're siphoning, you basically have to suck the wine to the loop bit, like that, and then put it in the bucket, as you can see, and then put it somewhere on the ground, like that. Alright, so what you're left with after you've siphoned it is a small amount at the bottom with sediment in and some clear wine in the fermentation bucket. Now we're ready to bottle. Okay, so we've sterilised our bottles. I've used this brew-safe, no-rinse cleaner sanitizer. But to be honest, I did rinse it because I didn't want any left inside. We're going to siphon into these green bottles using the siphon hose. Okay, so we have our wine. Before we bottle it, we want to sweeten it. This one's still got some sugar in it, so it's actually quite sweet. But we're going to add some glycerin. This stuff basically gives the wine its body. It can cause those little sort of beady marks on glasses when you drink it. It's got a little bit of sweetness in it, so we're probably going to start off with half a bottle, then taste it, and then if necessary add the other half of bottle. We can add some wine sweetener, but I think this one's quite sweet, so I'm not going to sweeten it anymore. Okay, so what we actually did is put the whole bottle in of glycerin. I'm going to give it a good stir with a sterilised spoon. Remember, everything has to be sterilised. And you just give that a taste. And that's actually pretty good. I'm ready to bottle it now. Okay, so we're ready to bottle our wine.
Again, we have to siphon it, so suck it to that point and then put it in and let gravity do its job.
Okay, so watching the bottle of wine fill. The trick is to basically stand up when you want it to stop filling. So we stand up and it comes down to that point, and then we're ready to do the next bottle. Okay, so we've got five and a bit bottles of wine. We're going to cork it now using a hand corker. So you basically, I've got these lubricated corks. You put them in there, stick that on, and then do that over the bottle, and I'll show you that next.
Okay, so you've got your bottle of wine. You want to put it on the floor, put the corker over the top, use your feet and push down. Need quite a bit of strength. Get it to go down. And that's it. Corked.
Okay, so we've got our corked bottle. If you want to be extra fancy, you can use one of these shrink wrap caps. So you just basically pop that on, you get a hairdryer.
Finger on the top. Just keep doing that, twisting it around until it's on and it'll look like this one.
As you can see, I've got a nice kind of clear wine, just like that. We can leave it for a few more months to mature, or you can drink it now. And here we have it, our finished ginger wine. I've made some labels, you can make your own, you can be quite creative, you can be quite funny, mine's just simply plain. This is the wine, tastes pretty good. Yeah, looks quite professional, ready to give as gifts or presents.